Hi students, this is Ramalakshmi, physics faculty. Today our topic is alternating current. So in alternating current, now I am going to discuss about alternating current through a pure resistive circuit. In this circuit, an alternating source is provided and a resistor of resistance R is connected to the alternating source. Now what is the nature of the alternating source? When alternating source is provided in the circuit, periodically the direction of alternating EMF at the same time alternating current changes in the circuit. That's why the direction of the current is represented on both sides. So this is the direction of current. So either positive to negative or from negative to the positive. Now what about the instantaneous value of the alternating EMF in this circuit? So source provides Vs is equals to V naught sin omega t, and in between the terminals of the resistor, what about the potential difference here? Let it be V R. By using Kirchhoff's voltage law, take the direction of the current is in clockwise direction. So now at the alternating source, Vs minus in the same direction of the current. Here current is I and resistance is R. So minus IR is equals to 0. And from this, we know Vs is equals to V naught sin omega t. So V naught sin omega t is equals to IR. And I is equals to V naught by R into sin omega t. Here V naught by I. V naught is the peak voltage, R is the resistance. So peak current I naught is equals to here V naught by R. I naught is equals to V naught by R. So substitute here, then I is equals to I naught sin omega t. So this is the alternating current in the circuit. I naught is the peak value of the current or maximum current in the circuit. So now once observe these two equations, alternating EMF and alternating current. So here what about the phase angle omega t, and here also omega t. So phase difference, the phase difference for alternating current and alternating EMF in case of the pure resistive circuit, phase difference is equals to 0. There is no phase difference in between alternating current and alternating EMF in case of the pure resistive circuit. So here, what is the nature of the resistor? Resistor always opposes the flow of electric current through the conductor. When resistor is connected in case of the DC circuit, we called that nature is resistance. When the same resistor is connected in case of alternating source, then we called that nature is impedance. Here, other than the resistor, there is no another device like inductor and capacitor. So in this case, resistance is equals to impedance. Both are same only. And what about the reactance? There is no capacitor and there is no inductor. Only this is pure resistive circuit. So reactance of this circuit is also equals to 0. So generally resistors are the passive devices. It doesn't produce any electrical energy or not consumes the electrical energy. But resistors converts the electrical energy in the form of the heat energy. In same way, resistors also not depends upon the direction of the current in the circuit. At the same time, frequency of the source also. In case of the DC currents, frequency is equals to 0. In case of the alternating currents, frequency is maximum. But even though when frequency varies from 0 to maximum, There is no change in the value of the resistance of the circuit. So, resistors not depends upon the frequency of the circuit. Graphical representation of the alternating current. So, in this case, both EMF and current periodically changes its direction. So, whenever periodically changes its direction, we represent with the sinusoidal wave. So, now this is the sinusoidal wave representation of both alternating EMF and alternating current. So, the first sinusoidal wave represents the alternating EMF and the second one represents the alternating current. So, both current and voltage reaches to the maximum point at the same instant of time. Here, V maximum and I maximum, and both becomes to minimum at the same instant of time, and both get the maximum, again maximum, but in opposite direction at the same instant of time. In this case, both are negative. So starting from 0 degree, both the EMF and current minimum, and at 90 degrees both are maximum. Again at 180 degrees both current and EMF minimum. Again at 270 degrees both maximum. Again at 360 degrees both get again minimum. So that means from this sinusoidal representation it is very clear to us what about the phase difference in between alternating EMF and alternating the current in case of the pure resistive circuit. Phase difference is equals to zero. Why? Because the frequency of alternating current and the frequency of the EMF both same. Same time they both reaches to the maximum and the minimum values. So the phase difference in between alternating EMF and voltage is equals to zero. So now these two are in phase. EMF and alternating current both are in phase. Same phase. So phase difference is equals to zero. So what about the power factor in a pure resistive circuit? Power factor generally cos phi. So here phi is equals to zero. Cos 0 degrees is equals to 1. So, power factor is equals to 1. Next, average power of this circuit. So, here average power is equals to VRMS into IRMS cos phi. Cos phi value is equals to 1. So, what about the average power of the circuit? VRMS into IRMS. This is the average power of the pure resistive circuit. So, pure resistive circuit doesn't depends upon the frequency of the source. It doesn't depends upon the frequency of the source. So, this is about the AC through pure resistive circuit. In next video, we will discuss about pure inductive circuit. Thank you, students. Have a nice day. Bye.